Hey, you. Iltiest. Come here. Word on the street has it that the theist have got you on the run. Something about objective ethics. They got you believing that you need God to believe in such a thing. And that your only alternative is some kind of weird whack job bit of Darwinian logistics. As you know, I represent the theist community here on YouTube. And I got a little secret I don't think they want me to be telling you. I promise not to be a snitch. I'll let you in on it. I like you, you know? Alright. Truth is, my atheist friend, you don't need God to demonstrate objective ethics. You don't even need Darwin. How do you do this? Huh? Word on the street is real slick these days. Something about oughts and is's. Whatever the fuck that means. I don't know. Neither do they. That's to your advantage. It's a real fashionable piece of bullshit or nonsense for the less vulgar. If you ever run into someone that says you can't derive an ought from an is, ask them why, and you'll find out as I did. They haven't a clue. It's just real fashionable nonsense, you know what I'm saying? Let me demonstrate for you. Say you want to paint a room, and you're faced with the question of how about going about it. Well, you're going to paint a nice color blue, something you picked out. It's your own personal preference, can't go wrong there. But then you're faced with the choice of painting your room with a toothbrush or a paint roller. What should you do? Well, as it turns out, the nature of problem solving is solving problems. And just like I can't answer the question, what is 2 plus 2? And answer, it's 4 plus 4 minus 4 times 10 divided by 10. And just answer with 4. Neither can you do anything that deviates from the most efficient path when you're solving a problem. Now to that, you got a very good criteria, you see, to paint in your room. Of those two options, what would be the most efficient way to paint the whole room with a toothbrush? Hey, you want to be cute, you can leave right now. You hear what I'm saying? Of course not, that's stupid. You'd paint with a paint roller. So would I. But some of you are smart and have deduced that this is not exactly a moral dilemma. And you're right. So let's talk morality then. This is the part they don't want you to hear. You see, a moral dilemma is just solving a problem that involves humans instead of tools. Do you know why? Because the needs of the tools are less important than the needs of the human being. But if your means to solving a problem is other human beings, then their needs are the same as yours. You see, you can't make your needs more important than theirs, or their needs less important than yours, or vice versa, at any time. Say, I want to employ you to paint my room a nice color of blue, and I even give you the paint roller, I'm so nice. But I'm not gonna pay you. I need my room to be painted, because I want it. You are going to use some of your energy. You're going to take your time that you could have been spending in any other way. And you're going to do it for something for me. Your needs are not being met quite in a fair way. Now are they? Now it's just painting a room. At the same time, I can't give you $1 million for this. That would be undermining my own needs for the little bit of energy that you're expending. And so we begin to haggle amongst ourselves to find out what is a fair arrangement. And you know, I never go back on my deal, so we agree to something. Maybe it's just a movie afterwards. Maybe I agreed to paint your room. Maybe it's money. Whatever it is, so long as we both agree and in the end we do not underestimate or overestimate our own needs against each other, we are making a moral decision. And that ought comes from the is of our problem. You see? God doesn't have anything to do with it. In the long run, if you believe God is the source of everything, then of course God is the source of ethics, but it ain't a book. You got it? It's the intuitive, logical force that you possess as a human being. All right, now get out of here before we sing together.